Well, I've just pulled up into a lay-by of the Oxford Canal, and we're going to go for a recce. That's me and my co-pilot here, if I just show you. Oi. That's my little co-pilot. We're going to have a little recce. We're going to see the Oxford Canal, aren't we? Going to see any fishes? Yeah. And if it's any good, we're going to have a fish. We're going to have a fish tomorrow. An hour. A whole hour's fishing. So we're going to have a look, see if it looks very fishy, and get our gear tomorrow and hopefully catch a few fish. That's the plan. Go on then, you.
Well, this is the Oxford Canal at Aynho on Station Road. There's a few more over here. There's a wide bit up there we're going to have a look at. It always looks fishy. I've been along here drop shotting, but I've never actually fished. So let's have a look.
What are you saying? What are you doing to this bit, Katie? Does that look alright? Does it look good? Oh, are you yawning? Is it nap time? Right then, I'm off fishing. Yay! The weather's great. No! We're going to catch some fish. Yay! Have I been around a baby too long? Yay! Oh dear. Right then, we are off fishing today. The weather is pretty pants. I think we've got fine rain all day, you know, the stuff that soaks you through, as Peter Kay would say. And we're gonna go on the Oxford Canal, as I promised, and we're gonna catch some fishes. I think I'm gonna fish a pole and bread, but I'm gonna have a look. I brought my lure stuff as well. If it looks horrible, if it looks like there's been a load of boats going up and down, then I might just rove around with my lure tackle instead. But if there's been loads of boats, it won't be great for lure fishing either, to be honest. It'll be chocolate and not very visible for the fish. But the Xander, you still catch a few Xander in that colour water and some big perch. Oh, that's a big lorry. That was a very big lorry. So anyway, so we're going to go. It'll take me nearly 15 minutes to get there. And we'll be set up fishing within the hour. Canal stall, keep net, that's my little pole bag, and that is all I'm taking. Can't get easier than that. Let's go.
Yeah, boat going backwards up the canal. Lovely. What is that boat doing? Where is he going? That's exactly where I wanted the fish. Oh dear. Where is that boat going? That does not look good. That's where I wanted to fish. Oh dear. Oh dear. That canal is absolutely chocolate. I want to fish for an hour. I'm not sure I'm going to catch there now. My God, what is he doing? There's a proper turning bay and he's gone straight past it. We'll give that a miss. And we'll go the other side of the bridge. That tree is where I saw a load of long-tailed tits when I walked along here last time. Yeah. So, I'm tempted to just fish here. Somewhere I can put my pole behind me. We'll go here. We will just go here. Bridge hole in, peg bridge hole. The pole will be behind me in the shape of that tree. Because the other side I was just going to use the hedge. We'll go here. What a lovely day. Bread. Got a few maggots and pinkers just in case. Not sure I'll need them. It's looking up lovely. Lovely. Make some more Bobby's porridge, this. I don't know if you can see that, but in front of me now, there's rubbish everywhere. That was the other side of the bridge. Now it's in front of me. It's probably going to be right over my peg in a minute. Right where I want to fish, and I am using some old rigs today. I've had these hooks ages, it's about time I used them up. I normally use probably a B511, although those PR311s were always a very good bred hook, a good bloodworm hook. I tend to use B511s for bread. It don't matter today. Does matter, is that raft of crap in front of me? Not good. So that's the depth across and that's the depth short. Look at that. That raft was 15 metres the other side of the bridge when I got here. Now it stopped and settled in front of me. What do I do? Do I move up or pray it's gonna carry on? Can't get over that. How am I going to get a rig through that? It doesn't look like it's going to move now. Unless the boat goes through. And is it going to go backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards? I'm going to pull it towards me. Some of it. See if that can help. Especially these bits. Look at that. Is that going to move? Get rid of these big bits. I might be out of fish. Can you believe it? What's the chances? What are the chances? Go on, carry on up there, out the way. Where's it come from? More to the point. Oh dear, we're going to have fun, aren't we?
Oh, it's going to be a fun one.
Right, let's feed.
Is that much short?
An instant response. Splop it in. Oof.
feet, a much larger amount. Well, relatively. I'm not going to feed bucket fulls because, well, feed a little bit more. That'll do. That'll do. Because I'm not fishing for long. I want an instant hit more than anything. And we were going to fish there, weren't we? Yeah. Swap it in.
Look at that lovely milky cloud.
Ring the dinner bell. These fish are going to be hungry now. And there we are.
Alright.
I'm going to start. A bit more positive down, bringing the shots down a bit, especially with that weed and that. Can't be laying the rigging sideways when it's like this. Well, it's like a strong bulk for bread. Just better get a slice of bread out, haven't we? Now this isn't my usual Warburtons, I'm afraid. It's Marks and Spencer's, believe it or not, and I'm not that keen on it. I don't really particularly like eating the Marks and Spencer stuff either, but I don't think it's particularly good for bread. It's getting forming. It's starting to form. Oh, it's starting to fight. I'm sure it's starting to fight. There's four. There's a 5 mil. I'm trying to keep the bread dry. Start on that. 5 mil, bit of bread. I expect an instant bite. I'm talking funny because I've got my bread punch in my mouth, which is where I like to keep it. I don't know why an Northern accent's come from. But my bread punch is in my mouth. And that's where I keep it immediately after punching. And then I go down, load it up again, back in the mouth. I've not tested this float yet, so it might take a little bit to get right. Just realised I've left my pole behind me as well, so I'll have to move that out of the way in a sec. I always give it a few seconds because it wait for the float to take on a little bit of water. That's not too bad at the moment. Keep laying the rigging amongst all this rubbish. Come on, fish. Oh. A little inquiry. Just let it run through. Go on. There's something there. Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, where's he gone? Tangled up. There we are. Not a bad fish to start with. A chunky roach. That bite was very, very funny. That certainly didn't take the bristle under. I've already got it loaded, I forgot. 5 mil punch. It'd probably take a 4 better. Pop that in. Have a boat coming. Load it up. Put my pole and get it out of the way. Any cyclists or anything for that? Oh, bit of a big twitch. That's a good sign anyway. A roach immediately. Five's nice to start on in case there's any skimmers or bream about. Did it. Right, what we're going to do, I'm going to put a shop on that, get an hour on it, 4mm punch nut. Inches off the deck now. The roach always like to fish it off the deck, to be fair. Often start on the deck just in case there's a big fish about. Be quickly off for those roaches. Fishing a top kit in one. Plenty of towpath behind me. Means I don't have to unship. But I get all the advantages of a short line. I'm not going to feed any more bread at the moment either. Fish it out, see what's about. I might not feed again. I might flick a frog pinching. Who knows? I know feeding regularly often brings in littler fish. So if you can catch off the first potful, we often catch a better stamp of fish. Should have gone under. Not sure why it didn't. Most of that rubbish has gone out of the way now. Although it's exactly where I fed across. I think we'll stay short for the time being. A dumpy roach, anyway. All up. Straight down this time. Three bites, three fish. Yeah. Oh yes. Look at that beauty. There, what we're after. Oh. Come gently in. Finding it back out the way of the cyclist. Even going that long line, that just I just lowered that one straight down, didn't I? Little trick. Oh, they're certainly not peas in the pod because I think they're five fish and they're all different sizes. Plop. off the hook. Always make sure that hook's really clean. Morning. Try just slightly upstream of it now, see if that makes a difference. Fish sometimes sit the other side of the bait. Oh, my stomach's rumbling. Even further off of that. You never know. Negotiate the rubbish. Don't get a bite, I'll go an inch off. See what happens. I'm not convinced they're off the deck actually. These sessions are nice for just trying things, you know. Right, I think this will go under now. Fishing an inch off now. Negotiate the rubbish. I think that'll go. A few more minutes on the short line and we'll go across. That's where the fish are going to be. Lovely depth against that boat. Come on. Come on. I could top up the ball. I want to keep the fish over there, I think. Or do I? Should I top up? I'm going to leave it and top up once I know how the far bank swim's doing. Nope. So, let's pop this on. That didn't sound good, did it? Yeah. That was a little crack, crap there. Still on there. There's not sound too clever. Nice little tree pole roll there behind me. take off. Four mil. If I don't go and bite immediately, I'll be very surprised if I negotiate all the rubbish. One way might be struggle pulling the fish through all this rubbish as well. Cross that bridge when we get to it. Right, straight away. Oh, and a mistake. Even I miss bites, you know. I missed a bite last year once and all. The rubbish has moved a bit. I'm going to change the slice of bread as well soon. It's just gone a little bit wayward. Long line above the float, don't bother me at all that. Negotiate the rubbish, as I said. Easy second done. That's a nice chunky roach. On punch. Oh no. Bread's come off. Whatever I say. If you think it, do it. Soggy. I don't roll my bread, but I will happily press it. Want it to stay on a bit better?
That's much better. Much better. God, look at all that rubbish I've got to ship through there. To drop that straight down again.
Oh dear. Ooh.
Good sliding away.
Should have had fun fishing. Just swing it up. Rubbish off, look at that. Just scored your job.
You. Lovely.
Disgorger under my ear.
It's the Irish thing today. Got a ship. Can't ship through the water. I've got all this canal and I chose to fish somewhere there's a load of rubbish.
Is it a big fish or just covered in rubbish?
Just swing the boat.
Imagine what I could catch if I didn't have to keep cleaning my rig after every fish.
splasher. There's a fish amongst that. I definitely just fish a bulk today, I think. I might change it in a minute. One more fish. Bulk and one dropper. God, I've got a wire stem float on now because it just cocks through all that rubbish. I have to go the other way this time. All that rubbish. Struggling to get over the bridge. Ooh. That's rubbish. I don't. I'm still on. Thought he'd come off. What's all that rubbish? I'm glad I've come this side of the bridge. One of the simplest, most effective ways of catching roach. An oval and a skimmer, not sure you'll catch many other species than roach. Good juniper in your peg, maybe even a chub, but I would say 99% of fish will be roach. Make live bread. Rubbish on the hook. You're not getting a bite when there's that many fish in the peg. Can't be a reason. Alright, let's try a much more positive setup. Bulk, one dropper, 352. Should do it. Nice positive setup. Even in an hour, you can do a lot of fine tuning and changes and different things. should bomb through that bait a bit quicker if nothing else. I'm not sure if it'll give me time to bait up before I go a bite though. Right in amongst that rubbish. Oh, and a bite. Considering that hook was tied about, what, 4 years ago. Doing right, innit? 20.07, the main line's 0.012, believe it or not. Which is nice and robust. I used to fish 0.08 to 0.06, even 0.06 straight through on the canal when I was younger, but nowadays I realise that that thicker main line is better. That thicker main line is much better. Hopefully the fish see it. Keeps everything stiffer, less tangles, and also falls through the water a bit better. More resistance. So it's win-win, and obviously it's stronger. A little bit to the right there.
Spread's already getting wet. The bait probably wouldn't have gone amiss today.
That tree elastic's perfect actually. Oh, now go shake the rubbish.
Nice one. Not a bad starfish. Whoop.
Nice. Might try a 5mm punch again and see what happens. To lose. Yeah,
it's towing a bit now, so I can lay it in properly.
I generally like to lay it in sideways for roach on a shallow canal.
Losing track of time, I'm not sure how much longer I've got.
Peas in a pod. And I certainly don't mind that bulk. See if they'll have this 5mm punch and get it in. That's all the rubbish. Straight away. And a bigger fish. Splashing against all that rubbish. Get it out. It's a bigger fish.
Ooh. Lovely. He splashed around a bit, but he came straight up with a load of branches.
And reeds or whatever it is. It's rain is surprisingly cold.
Good one. Oh, sorry mate.
How you doing?
Not so bad, you?
Alright.
2 secs.
Okay.
Every day.
Good dog fishing.
Yeah, I've had a few.
Yeah? Oh, there you go.
Only fishing for an hour.
Like
yeah, like a bit of water on the backs.
Yeah, yeah. That's lovely,
don't mind that 5mm punch.
How many bites have I missed? One? Two?
Ravenous fish. Right then. I'm going to catch 10 more fish and we're done. Get back, make sure my babby's behaving with my mum and dad. Bless them, good as gold. She's in a good mood this morning through a lovely hike yesterday.
Ooh, that's not funny very well, but we'll give it a go. Reach the bottom, there's weed around it. It's all bunched up around the peg. Can't get the rig in now. Yeah. Rubbish in the peg. Go on, get in there. Fish over there now if I wanted to.
Oh, hybrid.
Yeah.
Something different.
All that rubbish has stopped in front of my peg. I'm going to top up the short line. Ooh. Top up the short line. Have a go short. Not much. Yep, all that stuff just gathered in the peg where I can't fish.
I'll tell you what, we'll have a new slice of bread as well. Now I'm getting cold.
Yeah, that is it. All that rubbish. Hello. Lovely day.
Typical run up to the English bank.
Oh yeah. Rubbish has moved. We can get back over. I'm going to top up with a bit of bread. Just more than that. Down again. It's tiring a bit now, but I'm not too concerned. down these, the fish are a foot or so further down the peg. They will be. Right then, the plan now is I'm going to try and catch 5 fish, then I'm going home. Cold. Very cold today, that cold rain. It's supposed to be spring. Turn like a river now. Come on, fish. I think didn't like that top up, did they? Bring the float up. Spread the shot back out. Fish falling in the trench. Ship rubbery now, can't get a bite. Fish and why not catch one fish? I need a wee. Need a wee. Ooh, in the back. As I expected, topping up might bring smaller fish. These little wreckers are about trying to learn. There's one. 4 more to go. And they're back. Isn't it nice to be on a ship through the water?
I've run over the top to avoid branches.
There's 2. When I came here drop shotting, I actually had a jack pike, and they were scattering bleak and all sorts around these pegs. There's definitely a few pike in the area. Although I don't think that's what's scared the fish today, you never know. I just think my topping up's not helped. What's this? Freezing, so that's my last fish. What a nice fish to end off. Yeah. Lovely. I'm absolutely frozen. We all have that, haven't we? Every day. Look at that.
Yeah.
Look. Right, let's pack up, get home. Nice bag of fish, all different sizes. Some real nice ones in there as well. All on the bread. One little hybrid, all the rest roach, as I expected. And just on a few slices of bread. And a bit of white, sloppy white crumb. Look at that, eh? Lovely.